Let me first kick out the elephant in the room, why I chose Vue.js. I'll keep it crisp. I did consider using React and as well as Angular. But for my background, I was a full stack developer until 2014-15. And back then it was just three languages, JS, CSS, HTML and JavaScript. And we had this jQuery, and then we placed AJAX call the RESTful services, and that was the end of it. And I got into backend development, and when I came back in 2018-2019 time frame, I just felt that I have drifted a lot from the UI world. So there was a UI framework with every alphabet combination. So but when you do the research, you often hear the famous frameworks, namely Angular and React. But what I did was I started learning React.js first. Now when I see, I don't see much difference between React as well as Vue, because my terms will be sloppy because I'm not a UI developer, but for a person who wanted to dip his toes into the UI world after a very long time, you can even consider this a first time. It was kind of a surprise, a cultural shock, like how things have merged and diverged and came back in place. And now when I started learning React using a Udemy course from Maximilian Academind, the course was like 40 hours. So, and whenever you want to do a research upon which framework to choose, I use the Stackshare.io. Stackshare.io is a wonderful website where you can get to know a lot of tools out there in the market, like what are all the tools available. You can do a research over there and get to know a lot of tools which is trending and all. So, React is always the top. And there is also a kind of a marketing going on there, because React as well as Angular are both backed by corporate giants, but Vue is groomed by a community of developers. And so I started learning React. I kind of felt it difficult, and whatever material I saw, it was over 20 hours, 40 hours, etc. So I found Vue.js, and then I found a sponsor somewhere who is sponsoring the website, because whenever you look at community-based tools like Spring Framework previously, now Spring is backed by Pivotal, but so Vue.js sponsors were like Vue Mastery, Vue School and all, like for example, So I tried Vue School first, and then I didn't like the courses, so I came back to Vue Mastery. So Vue Mastery has these courses which has they have the beginner path, the intermediate path, the advanced path. So for that mini project, whatever I have chosen, beginner path was more than enough, but so I chose the 1 hour course for intro to Vue.js. It was really elementary. You will be surprised like how quickly you can put together a UI application, and then going to real world Vue.js was a complete transition, because whatever you learned in this course is all the basics, and that they will help you in the second course, but it will be a complete transformation into a real world production grade project. They introduce you to the UCLI, UUI and all. So I started mastering Vue.x, but I'm not a UI developer, and I don't want to go deep into it. So whatever I did, this project, whatever I have in place here, these actions, the token getting created, placing the order, something coming up, all these things I was able to do by just doing the first 2 hours of course. That is more than enough. And you need to have maybe a basic understanding of what JavaScript can do, what CSS can do, what HTML can do. So that is enough. So from that aspect, I was able to find a very good material which will make my pace really fast and to make such a deliverable easy. So that is why I chose Vue.js. I even try to search for documents where they compare React, Angular, and says Vue is the best. But it's like, I don't want to be biased anywhere. I just went with what I found first. I tried React, but now when I see React after trying Vue, I don't see much difference. But that's the reason I chose Vue. In just a matter of 2 hours, I was able to put together an application, which was, I was self-satisfied with the output, whatever I got, the ease, how I'm achieving this totaling function, how I'm able to click something, and after clicking, making everything go back to zero. These were done with very minimal lines of code. I'm pretty sure React has the same capability. But yeah, so that's the reason I chose Vue.js. I want to stop right there. Let us start with installing Vue. You can just Google and find out the way. I'm using a Mac. There are multiple flavors how you can install. I'm using npm install Vue. Vue comes up with a lot of goodies like Vue. If you don't like using CLI, you can use Vue UI to generate projects. I'm going to show that. And I'm using Vue 2.0 and Vue 3.0 is out. And looks like it is a complete rewrite, and there are a lot of talks about this specific API called as Composition API. And you can learn about those things here. I forgot to mention something here. When you choose the beginner path, when you go to Vue Mastery, the first course is free. But to go to second course, I think only the 3 lessons are free there. For anything more than that, you need to pay. I paid for 1 month of subscription, and I was done in like 2 days, so I cancelled it, but it is still available for me for the next 20 days, I guess. I learned Vue 5 days ago, or maybe 10 days ago, I guess. So, yeah, that is one point I want to mention. Now, since I have something already installed, let me go to my downloads directory, because that is the directory I always clear by end of the day. And then I'll go run Vue CLI or Vue UI. When I run Vue UI, it will launch the Vue UI application, which is basically a Vue project manager in my localhost 3000, 8000. And if you go to the more option right here, you have the Vue Project Manager. Right now I have 2 courses. The first one is the course what I learned from Vue Mastery. The second one is what I created. New project, I want to create under my downloads folder, and because that is a folder I clear by the end of the day. Name, I'll just choose demo app. And then package manager is going to be npm. I think by default it is yarn, I guess. Yarn is yet another resource, I don't know, npm. I don't want a Git repository, but you can just have it as a Git repository so that it will be having all those Git init things done for you. Nothing of this sort is needed without, okay, next. And then I know only Vue 2, so I'm choosing default preset for Vue 2. There is a Vue 3 and then a manual and remote preset. You need to know in and out of Vue at least some high level things like Babel, ESLint, where you want to keep the code pretty so that certain compilers will throw error. Create the project. Approximately it took about 5 minutes, I guess, 4-5 minutes. It could even be my connection. So if you go to Vue Project Manager, this is our application. And I'm going into it. So we have this plugins, dependencies, configurations, and tasks. Dependencies is like you can go ahead and search, just like Maven dependency if you are in Java world, or Nugget if you are in the .NET world. You can just go and search for lint. You can start installing things. So go to install dependency, and you can search for. There are multiple utilities you can think of, and you can install them. So such a thing is JSON server. Yeah, I installed this because if you want to get your code running with a fake mocked API, you can install that. That's how you install it. Just go ahead and install JSON Server, and those dependencies will be added to your package, just like your Maven POM XML for UI projects, especially those based upon Node.js projects. You will be having something called as package.json file, where you will be having those dependencies, and dependencies installed is the message what we get here. And plugins are like where you, I think I added a plugin for Bootstrap. Yeah, this one, CLI plugin. Yeah, I think I used this. So where we are going to we are going to use a Bootstrap, which is basically a component library, a beautified. Just it will make sure that you don't need to have you don't need to worry about the beautiful components in your UI. Like for your UI to look more appealing, they have a lot of components like the error message component, carousel, card, collapse, drop downs, Jumbotron. You would have seen all these things in the recent applications. I used Bootstrap when it was in version 1.0 or 2.0, and now since this is a very famous component library, just like Material UI, they have a very specific version built for Vue framework. And when you see my UI screen, I have taken components from this screen and have modified the CSS color properties and made it look like this. I don't think I'm very good with colors, but this is what I come up with. So this is the card, what you see here. This is the code for that. I chose that, and that is the reason I have multiple cards here. And what you see here is called a Jumbotron. Jumbotron is this one where you have it as a rectangle, but I have it in a vertical fashion over there. And then what else do I have here? I have this buttons. So button, I have this success button, and you can see it here. And blue means default. So button, the default color is blue. That's what I have, the primary. So these are the things I have used, mostly Bootstrap based. And for that to work, we need to add to the UI. You need to just include this plugin for that to work. So once you have this, I'm using Visual Studio Code. So let us go ahead and open the new application, whatever we just now created. So I know that it is in my downloads folder under the folder name demo. Open that. And here you go. So whatever dependencies you ask for will be present here. Never touch the folder. Public. Yep. So the key components are present here. So if you run the application, if you want to run this application, you need to go to the tasks. First, build it. So when you want to I'm getting too much into Vue, but I'm just going to make sure that I don't talk a lot about it. But you start the application, you build the application. This step is necessary for you to deploy this application into a server of your choice, because the frameworks like Vue.js, React.js, Angular.js, all are there in place to just to make your life easy, doing things with a certain kind of programmatical way. But end of day, you're going to deliver only HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to the browser, because browser doesn't differentiate between this is a React application, Vue application, and all. So for that, you'll be creating something called as a distribution. When you see here, dist folder is the final output with CSS, minified CSS, image, JS, all this index HTML. If you just drag this and put it in your browser, it will still work. So this is the folder which will be deployed to the server where you want to launch the UI application. So, but we will not be using that, we'll be using real-time UI, whatever we have here. So now let us serve the application, run the task, and let us see which port is being chosen here. I already have an application running, let's see whether it is a conflict. Okay, so if you go to the output, okay, 8080. Okay, this is a sample application. What do you have here? So if you this what whatever com is coming here is through the Vue framework. So if you go to the components, the app, what it is doing is it is having something called as a component, the Hello World component. The Hello World component is present into the Hello World folder, and what you see here is the essential links, ecosystem, and installed CLI plugin. So if you see the UI, this is what this UI. So Vue.js, React.js, all these things are building UI like a stack, keeping one over the other, putting things together and mixing it and delivering it so that you can keep codes in a module fashion. So they have made a component called Hello World View, and they have included that here. So if I include the component 3 times and save it, I think I can see the output immediately. See? So it is that easy nowadays. And I'm talking as if I'm very old, but that is the fact, it is very easy. So you whatever component you think of, even the smallest component like this, if you want to place a component over here, component over here, you just develop those components as separate files and register them and put it together in one place like a main application called app.view. That is how I have put my application together. Now we're done with a basic project setup. Whatever change you do here, welcome to demo. It is that fast. So it is so reactive. So now let us go ahead and look into something called as a code pen. I want to talk about code pen because that is another place where you can hunt or pouch for very good UI components, especially for Vue or any other UI framework. So it'll make your life kind of easy. There is another website where you can go ahead and look for good UI I mean like professional level or code that are very intuitive, UI designs achieved with very minimal number of lines or very to give you ideas. Like for example, I was searching for view notifications. What I have here is one way of showing things that the order has been placed. But what I wanted to show was something like this. For example, if you can just go and search like view notification. And I wanted to do something like this, where you can actually have this code in place. So if you, it's a working code. It's just like any other fiddle. It is just a fiddle kind of website where you can just see what kind of output you're getting. The green shade, the red shade, the blue shade. So if you like this, you can fork it. If you have an account, you can fork it and do changes and then finally download. Or if you want to use it as such, you can just go ahead and export and export the zip. Looks like they have an embed option nowadays. And then you also have this Pro, that is the overkill for whatever we have. So that is how you use code pen. For example, if you want to use certain bootstrap features, like you can search for bootstrap cards. Where is my S? Cards view, such like that. Nothing came up. Okay. Bootstrap card or view cards. So these are the examples what you can achieve using Bootstrap and view put together. So I'm pretty sure you'll be having. Yep. So what you have here is a Bootstrap component done in a Vue style. So if you just export this as a project, you will be given a Vue project with this output. You can then start wiring the actual logic and stop this hard-coded data. So that is one easy way of putting together an application, just copying and pasting, just like whenever we have an issue and whenever we have some kind of a very peculiar issue, we go to Stack Overflow and copy the code and put it and then learn about it. This is one way of doing the UI world. If you are not familiar with UI, this is a right place to start, and that is Codepen. JSON Server is another plugin what I'm using here. We right now have a working API gateway because we did a backend first approach. And for example, for API first design, you design an API, and the UI team or whomever is going to consume our API goes in their direction, and we as developers who are going to develop the API backend go in our direction. And when we are both done with our sprints, we come back, just switch the endpoints, and see that if our contracts match, and if we both worked on the same contract, our deployment will be successful. So until then, if you want to have sample data, JSON Server is one way to do that. So let me go ahead and stop the application, whatever we have here. We are stopping it. And I'm going to start the application, what I have, Bootstrap, because that also runs on 8080. Let me go ahead and run it. And I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. Meanwhile, let me open that code in Visual Studio Code. Because whatever UI you saw before that, this beautiful images with all these prices came in, it was from a mock data. So the purpose of JSON Server is that you go to my code base. I'll just show it and you'll get it immediately. You need to go ahead and create something called as some JSON file, and it should represent the same message whatever you're going to consume from the backend. So our assumption right now is the backend is not ready. So we created a sample mock data in this format. We are going to return something called as items, and it is going to give something called as a array of objects, and we will be consuming that in our JS using localhost 3000. So for you to serve the data, if you have installed this JSON, if you have installed this JSON server package, I think I can find an entry for that here. So if you have that ready in your local, you just need to go into the path, just type JSON server and db.json. I know I have my, the Chrome has the memory of it. So if I go ahead and call localhost 3000 and items, I will not be getting any. But the moment I start this, here is it. JSON server db.json. It will start serving the mock data. So if you go back to the browser and call it now, it is rendering the data. And if you refresh the application now, it is displaying what we have, what we want. So I will again go back to my code base and explain what each and every entity or component is in my screen. But what I'm saying here is, until your main API, the production API or development API is ready and you are a UI developer, JSON Server plugin is an excellent component where you can mock the data and start wiring the UI. And once the backend actual endpoint is ready, you can just flip it and application just works. So that's about JSON Server. I went to the view UI. I started the view UI, started the application, and I have this open in my browser. I have kept the developer tools ready. And I have this FoodTrip application, which is rendering this application. The code base is here. And this code base is what we first installed, demo project, whatever we did, the plain project from the view itself. So I'm going to just contrast and show you what I have changed. So the world, I deleted the hello world view and I created something called as food truck home screen view. And then I kept the app view as such. And instead of the hello world component, I'm telling use the food truck component because app view is the one, the mother component, the root component, which will display the other components in the way however you want to display. We have only one component, and that's the reason I have this here. I can still go ahead and divide the screen into multiple components, like the items will be one component, the order jumbotron will be another component, but I just want to keep it simple because the whole idea is we are building a serverless project. We are not building a production grade UI application. Being my UI skill is very sloppy. And then so to understand, and what you see here is a services folder which I have added, which is not present in the by default one. Axios is a an external dependency, just like the JSON server I showed you. It which makes your life easy for making Ajax calls or the RESTful calls, external system calls. You can compare that to the Fane client in Java world, or you can compare that with any client like Jersey client, or it's just a Ajax call done in a very more in a more high level API kind of format. And so right, I haven't even wired the order items yet. So just the get items is working. So that is the only difference. And we have the Bootstrap Vue.js, the CSS, the button color, green color, a blue color. All you see here is flowing from the Bootstrap Vue.js component, and that was possible because I have added that plugin. If you don't have a plugin folder here, but you have a plugin folder here because I have added that Bootstrap Vue.js plugin. Let me see if I'm able to show that for you here. Yeah, see, I have this plugin added to my project. So, and because since I added it, it's not official version. These are the official plugins. This is the plugin what I added manually. So that is one another difference. And anatomy of a Vue.js file. A Vue.js file is a file that helps you build a component on a UI screen. So if you take this screen into account, what you see here is one component, the sidebar. The main body is one component. What you see here in the top, the add view router, add view X, all these things are called the nav bar, another component. So when you want to, so and app view is a place where you go ahead and add all these three components, and they represent themselves in the way how they are built. So when I say that, you need to understand that the anatomy of a view file. A view file is made up of all three languages that make up a UI application: the HTML, the JavaScript, and CSS. So you have the CSS code here, you have the JavaScript code within the script tag, and you have the HTML code under the template tag, you have the JavaScript code under the script tag, and CSS code under the CSS style tag. When I mentioned that the term scoped, which means that whatever style I have mentioned here is applicable only for this component. So if I define a list HTML component anywhere outside this particular component, it is not applicable. So that is the word meaning of scoped. It is self-explanatory. The colors, whatever you see here, title color, the yellow color, what you see here is flowing from the definition what I have here. And the background color for the cards, this crazy color, I don't know why I came up with this color, is coming from this. And leave that. The two important things you need to understand here is there is something called as binding. So for us, let us define the variables we have on the screen. The variables are the item description, the item price, a variable to store the order total, and what else? That's it. A variable to store the image, the variable to store the list of items to be displayed on the screen. That being said, we first need to come up with the variables what this component is going to have. Items variable will hold all these items being displayed here. Order is again items, but only when you click the add to cart, the order will be populated with whatever item was clicked. Total is one which is calculated on the fly, whatever is being displayed here. And then enable place order is when I first launch the application, I will not be able to click this place order button. For that, I have a Boolean variable, and that is I will talk about that in a few seconds. And then finalize total is for a programmatical convenience. I don't know what rule I'm breaking here, but I'm using that for a hack purpose, I would say. So now we have these variables that are used in this UI application, UI screen, and created. So just like any other component being built, like for example, when you write a unit test case, you'll be having a setup phase, arrange phase, act phase, assert phase, and then a teardown phase. When you build a UI component, you will be having a creation, post-creation, rendering, post-rendering, destroy, post-destroy. It changes between UI frameworks. So what I'm telling here is, there are multiple stages. I know only created, but if you go to Vue.js documentation, you can see what are all the stages available and when do you want to kick certain things in. And I'm telling, make sure that when this component is created, make a call to this API and get all the data, display this data here. So that's why I'm placing a call to food services, what we saw there, and calling the get items, and we are populating the items variable. The moment you populate the items variable, the items array will be filled. But how is it represented in UI? Yes, we have this v4. V4 is a, if you have worked with something called as a JSP or a Mustache framework or any kind of Jinja Python framework, it is a way of templating engine where you can write for loops, if blocks, switch case statements and all. So you say that we have a for loop, and this for loop will execute for the number of items you have, and every item is made up of three different variable properties: item image URL, item name, and item price. And I'm using that for image URL, I'm using the image tag. For displaying the item name, I'm using H5 tag, and price for P tag. That's how it's like self-explanatory. So I'm basically getting the items and iterating and populating this card. So that is how. So you should consider this component as one human being or one entity that will react for anything that changes. So when you populate the data over here, this is the same item I'm referring here in this for loop. This items, whatever the whatever you have defined here in this variables, that is the same thing I'm referring there. If you add something using a script, if you add something using a, for example, if I have a add item button here and I click that and add a new item by calling the post item endpoint, and still type the same variable, do it through UI, do it through script, do it through whatever means you have. If the variable is used anywhere in the component, it will be affected immediately. So there are a lot of anti-patterns here, which means that you cannot alter certain variables within certain code chunks. But what I'm trying to say here is, created is the phase in which I'm calling certain functions. And for our need, we're calling the get items function, which will display the menu item and be ready. And then methods property will hold all the JavaScript method we'll be calling whenever we'll be doing certain actions on the UI screen. Add to order is when it is called when I click the add to cart button. So when I click add to cart button, where exactly is this? Add to cart button is here. I'm calling the on click. These are all Vue way of doing things. If you take the Vue mastery course I mentioned before, you'll be able to understand that in like 2 hours. And you call that, and then place the order is called when I click the place order button, and clean up previous order is called when once I add a cart, click the close me button. I'll be calling the cleanup previous order. And filters is what I didn't learn from View Mastery, but later found out, because whenever I started adding these things together, the total was being built, but the decimal point was out of control. So I used something called as, looks like there's something called as filters, where you can format the data that's getting rendered. And then computer is a place where you can go ahead and let us see. Now I have to order and just increment the order total. And computer is a place where you can actually compute on the fly events. For example, on a screen load, I'm telling this is a disabled button. And then when the first item is added, it becomes green in color. And that is done using this computer. It says that if the order length is equal to 0, disabled is true, which means it will be gray. If it is not 0 anymore, it is changed back to clickable button. So this is all this screen does, and I have used the I have used V for V keys, where you give individual component ID for every card. So if you choose a card and inspect it, every card will be having this ID, and then CSS style, so you get it right. So that's how the CSS is wired. So there are parts where I want to change. I want to display the order UID that comes back from DynamoDB here. I'll be working on that in the next episode. And finally, what we will be doing here is we will be, as a last part of this whole series, we'll be working on this JS file, where I will be, when I place the item, I actually call the post order item endpoint, whatever we created, and returning back order ID to this pop-up, and that will be the end of it. And then I'll be wiring this to the actual endpoints what we have here. And as a last step, we will be deploying this application to AWS Amplify. AWS Amplify is again a serverless component, where it is just like a S3 static hosting, it is free until a certain amount of GB downloads, and of course it is a serverless way of doing things. AWS Amplify, it has a way of identifying the framework you're going to deploy, so it'll identify itself that you're deploying a Vue.js application, and that will be the end of it. So that's it for the UI part of it, and I know it was more like kind of flaky, because I was just doing it in my own way. I didn't learn the right way, but that's how it works. Thank you.